Simple Path to Wealth, Your Guide to Financial Freedom. Written by E.A. Sparks. Narrated by Michael F. Ward. Introduction. Money can make life miserable. That may sound strange, but it's true. If you don't have the right mindset about money, you can indeed feel overpowered by it. That's how millions of people out there feel because they have no clue how to make peace with their finances. Everybody wants to be in a position where they don't have to go to work every single day and just wait for the paycheck at the end of the month to be able to pay all sorts of bills and then again get back to the same cycle. But that's how life is for most of us. We know we need more money to be able to get out of debt, to be able to afford the things that may seemingly improve or upgrade our lives, and to have more time and freedom to live life on our own terms. You know what? No matter how much you wrestle with the idea of making more money and becoming wealthy one day, it's not going to take you anywhere. The reason is quite simple. It's you who has to change your attitude toward money for the situation to turn around. The power to master money is within you. There's nothing that can stop you from creating wealth and becoming financially independent. Whether it's the overbearing debt obligations, feeble credit history, or meager paycheck every month, none of it has the power to take away what you can do to live debt-free, have more money in your bank account, fulfill your dreams, and look forward to a fulfilling retirement. You haven't been able to get on the path of wealth creation so far because you haven't taken charge of your finances yet. You've lived unaware, enslaved, and deterred by money. But it's never too late. You can change your financial destiny as long as you're willing to educate yourself about how to manage your finances, stay out of debt, and make your money grow. The rules of money are the same for everyone, whether you're born rich or poor, employed with the best companies or earn a small salary. Every single person can lose or create money. It's all about what you think of money and how you treat it. To begin with, you need to understand that money is not just a medium which is meant to facilitate you. Thus, you don't need to get controlled by it. When people allow money to control them, they live worried and anxious about how they're going to pay the next set of bills, and they often feel drowned in the uncertainty of the future. On the other hand, when you learn to control money, you live peacefully and aren't scared of what's coming ahead. So, how do you achieve that? Well, that's exactly what this book is going to unveil for you. You need to think about your personal finances like a project of your life, which will help you handle money strategically. The reason why most people spend money wastefully and pay high interest on their credit cards is because they aren't aware of the easier and smarter way to meet their needs and desires. They want to live in the moment and gratify their impulsive whims and fancies, not realizing they're accumulating bad debt, which is hard to pay back. When people think about the idea of spending carefully and saving for the future, it makes them feel as if they're going to miss out on something fun, or their peers might get ahead of them. But that's not true. You can afford anything you like and have a more enriching life if you simply get conscious about your spending and take your future into perspective, which is why you will need certain financial goals. While everybody does think about buying a house, traveling, and retiring someday, they don't know the path to get there. However, the path is right there ahead of you. All you need is a little bit of understanding, knowledge, and willingness to improve your finances in order to see it. The day you begin to feel accountable about your money and implement a plan as to how you'd like to spend that money, save for retirement, and also look for ways to channel it to work for you, there's nothing that can keep you from creating wealth. You don't have to feel overwhelmed by your finances because it's your own choices that direct the course of your financial trajectory. You simply need to believe in yourself and become more self-aware to change your financial destiny. After you've read this book, you'll know how to manage your money so that it's never scarce. You'll learn the importance of making investments and growing your financial assets. You'll understand the stock market and cryptocurrency are not scary terms, and they're definitely not a gamble. Anybody can develop expertise to invest their money and make it work for them. There's huge money to be made through real estate investments, which most people assume is out of reach for them. Apart from that, you'll also learn about how an additional source of income can help you get out of debt faster and aid in your financial progress. It's never a bad idea to want to make more money because it contributes to your financial stability. Remember, we don't want to make oodles of money to compete with somebody else or be able to surpass our peers. We want to have enough money to savor the quality of life. There's nothing wrong in desiring more freedom of time to be able to go after goals that truly matter. When you don't have to worry about paying debt, it gives your mind mental peace, and you're able to enjoy your relationships better and nurture all the meaningful things in life. Money is definitely the key to the way we shape our lives. The good news is that you can take action toward not allowing money to go out of your pocket inadvertently. You can decide to fix your gaze on the future and all the dreams that you'd like to realize someday, which will empower you to work toward building wealth. So, are you ready to get ahead of the pitfalls of money and attain wealth? Chapter 1, Money Management. The more your money works for you, the less you have to work for money. Idwu Koyenikin. The foundation of good finances is managing money wisely. There's no other formula or recipe for creating wealth. It's a relationship you need to share with the money you earn that motivates you to build it. If you aren't aware of where your money is going every month, you'll always be clueless about your finances as a whole. It's the simple things that really make a big difference to how things take their course. The difference between those who budget and those who don't is not really the income or inheritance they have, but it's the confidence and assurance of knowing their finances. You need to come to terms with your money. How do you do that? Well, that's where budgeting and tracking your expenses come into the picture. Start budgeting. Whether you like it or not, budgeting is an integral aspect of building a strong financial future, so you better embrace it for your own good. You can make lots of money, but it's going to sustain you only when you manage it prudently. There are all kinds of budgeting styles to pick and choose from. The end goal is to spend consciously and save for the future. The purpose of budgeting is to train your mind to take charge of money. The purpose of budgeting is to train your mind to take charge of money and not let it enslave you. Thus, each person should start budgeting as soon as they start earning. The sooner you begin, the earlier you can establish a solid financial base for yourself. The 50-30-20 method of budgeting. With the 50-30-20 budgeting method, you can really structure your finances and know exactly how you want to use your money. This method doesn't just allow for you to spend on your desires, it ensures that you have enough money to pay for all your necessities every month. In addition, you still have money left for debt repayment and to allocate toward future savings. Let's examine how this works. To implement the 50-30-20 budget, you need to first know your net income after tax income, and then decide to spend 50% of it on your needs, 30% on your wants or desires, and use the remaining 20% to pay off your outstanding credit card balances, mortgage, or loans, as well as to fund your savings. Now, how much you want to use for debt repayment and how much for savings depends on how much debt you have. If you have quite a lot of debt, paying it off on priority makes more sense. Once you're out of debt, or at least have reduced the burden to a great extent, you can begin boosting your savings. Now, you also need to categorize your expenses, meaning list down your necessities and wants to be able to take advantage of this budgeting strategy. Don't confuse wants with needs. If you feel like buying a new pair of shoes for a party, it's a desire and not a necessity. On the other hand, paying your rent, buying groceries, and paying your electricity or water bill are all absolute necessities.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.